sure what I'm working on today yet. Just trying to get flexible. I am, I guess, now 2.5 days or 3 days into this first set of DR strings on the bass. Feeling really good, intonation still great, no slipping or anything, so that is fantastic. Fantastic news. Speaking of news, we have ROSK2828 is the winner of our latest giveaway, copy of the Union CD, Bass Player's Warm Up, Jazz Vocabulary for Electric Bass 251, and Bass Player's Guide to Looping. I just announced that on Instagram, posted a little video, sent a DM, so RossK2828, if you're watching this, check your Instagram so we can get your address and send this stuff out to you. And also, Bass Player's Guide to Looping, last 2 days, 3 days now of our 50% off book of the month, both physical and digital. Links are below. But congratulations to Rosk, or RossK2828. That's awesome. It's so fun to pick the winner and know that like somebody took the time. I really appreciate, first of all, everyone taking the time to comment and tag people and follow the rules of the competition, the giveaway, and just participate. That really means a lot. Like the outpouring of like hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people commenting below the post was really, I really appreciate that. The fact that people are engaged and that they care enough to hang out and take a few seconds of their time, of your time to be involved. That really, really means a lot. Oh, here we go again. Sorry, people. Gotta get the DND happening before I hit record. Anyway, yeah, so just thank you. I know how. And then not just that, people who take the time to listen to the podcast, I know there are 1,000 other things you could be doing with your time. So if you are choosing to spend a little bit of probably your most precious commodity as a human being, if you're choosing to spend a little bit of that with me and with this podcast and being engaged in what I do, I just have to say, and I don't say it enough, I have to say how much I appreciate that. That is very, very important to me. So thank you. And PSA is over, and maybe I can find out what I'm working on today. Where is that? That 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, okay. Okay. So that's a little bit of a challenge. I don't think I've ever done that one before. This is a good one. This is a good string crossing exercise. Can do it descending. I'm just going whole steps. Okay, let's try a half step away from that. So now I've gone in all 12 keys. Interesting. Okay. Maybe minor thirds. Why is that a brain block? Wow. Now I know it's G flat there. And then A. Sometimes when I'm working on stuff like that and I know I have a destination, I'm trying to think almost like a chess player or a snooker player or something, like a few moves ahead. If the mechanics of what I'm doing, of the shape, are fairly sound and I don't have to concentrate too much on simply getting the notes in the right order, then I can move my focus to where my next stop is. So I'm already preparing for the fact that a minor third away is E flat, is F sharp, is A. C. Let's try to do minor thirds a half step out. So B, D, F, A flat, B. Okay, not bad. So I'm always coming up with just little kind of seemingly, it's very simple. Rudimentary. I'm amazed I haven't done that exact exercise before, but that's just testament to the fact that there are so many combinations, so many options that we can literally never run out of stuff to practice. Might be onto something here. Maybe not. No, let's try F in the beginning. Stick with the idea, hang on. Too much like something else, and I want to get something totally different. Okay, back to mechanics for a minute. Ah. By this wider string spacing, and it does mean the strings sit over the poles of the pickups a little better as well. Kind of nice to have that adjustable bridge. I think it's a hip shot bridge. It's a dusty bridge is what it is. But yeah, nice to have that option and have a little wider string spacing. Now I'm guessing that the string spacing isn't completely even between the lower strings and the higher strings, but also that is not bothering me technically so far. Feels good. Okay, let's go. Bass players, warm up. Oh, my new favorite exercise. Really good for the right hand, actually, this one, in keeping this shape traveling across the strings. I like this. Now I'm thinking about it too much and screwing it up, so reset here. Okay, pretty good. I did go in with the TC Electronic edit thing, the tone print editor. Still couldn't really dial exactly what I was looking for. It sounds like a lesser known character on a Star Wars movie or something. Thank you. Second, get back to it. What's the melody? Connecting points. To get from a kind of outside thing. To an inside thing. I don't know why I'm feeling like playing kind of medium up swing vibe. Loop. Why is that first note so loud? One, two, one, two, 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 two. Thank you. vein, but let's get some more changes happening here. Okay, let's go F, D flat, G to C. And take the delay off the walking. Position right now, just kind of bleh. Don't know why. Have those days when it doesn't really flow the way you'd like. I guess that's the signal to just dial it back. Do something simple. Uh-huh. Used to have one that was something like that. Interesting. I always find I'm starting that one on F for some reason. Been noticing that. Got to try and kick that habit. Maybe go a half step away. So as I don't get any kind of ruts or habits. A little sloppy. Same place. Almost the same place. Let's do an octave down. I just missed a bunch of notes in the middle. So C, now we get to F. Feeling kind of distracted today. Yeah, I chose correct note over time there. I was in slight hesitation about getting the top one, and I broke the time. That's not a good habit to be in. Better to play the whole thing, I guess, in time. Okay, feels pretty good. It's going down. Okay. Oh, shake out the wrist a little bit. Where are we? C sharp, we've got F sharp. Okay, and we are back to E. Oops. Cool, and yeah, some people chimed in on the last episode about supplements. Supplements from GNC and other stores are typically a waste. Make sure you're getting pharmaceutical brands like Douglas Labs, etc. Yeah, I definitely get a high-end. I use a company called Thorn Research. Seem to be pretty happening. And I didn't even mention what I was taking yesterday. That was silly. I just chomped them down and moved on. I take a multivitamin, two of those. I take beta-alanine. I take creatine. I do this theanine caffeine thing, which is kind of a replacement for that. AI Reload that I used to take. And then what's the other one? Oh, and some turmeric. Some turmeric tablets. Been helping the inflammation and stuff with my back and stuff. Seems to be helping a little bit, which is good. Let's see. Carl Cherry asks, hoping that you will possibly share or offer your HX Stomp presets. Yeah, I'm sure there's going to be, once I have them dialed in, I'm sure I'll put them out there in some form. Kind of excited to share that, but they're not so close to being really ready to be like, okay, this is it. And they'll probably always change as well. Let's see. Somebody chimed in. Of course there was going to be someone says supplements are a waste of money. Just eat a balanced diet. Yeah, well, there's actually not a lot wrong with doing both things. Taking supplements and eating a balanced diet. And sometimes there just aren't enough hours in the day to prepare that many fruits and vegetables to eat. That's like a massive task. If you're interested in good old-fashioned joint and brain health, somebody's saying here, Rowan Barrett, about cod liver supplement. Yeah, some fish oils and stuff. I totally agree with that. I do take some of that stuff from time to time. But I just have like a regular daily thing with those 10 pills. And I'll take like other doses of beta-alanine when I'm training a little harder. But yeah, good to throw in some health stuff in here. It's always... It's sort of 90% of the process is being in good health and taking care of yourself and eating well, hydrating. I mean, that's a huge part of it, is having this water bottle here on hand. I use a thing called Drip Drop, which is like electrolytes and minerals and stuff, which isn't just straight water. If I'm sweating a lot in training, like that can flush out a lot of minerals and stuff from my body, so I need to replenish that rather than drinking just water. It's kind of a myth that drinking lots of water is a great way to hydrate you. It actually kind of cleans you. As far as I understand, it actually cleans a lot of minerals out of your system and doesn't necessarily put them back in if you're drinking too much. Obviously, this is all, you know, everyone's body is different, first of all, and everyone needs more or less of certain things. But as a general rule of thumb, I'm trying to replace the minerals and electrolytes in my body, especially as I train quite a bit, you know, on the tennis court and in the gym, and I do sweat a lot. Yeah, just all part of trying to keep the mind and the body safe from injury and healthy. I was talking to Dave Weckl about that the other night, and Frank Gambale and a few of the guys, like they're both 60 and 61 respectively, and you know, Dave, for instance, is in great shape, and Frank seems super strong and happy and very, has a lot of clarity in his thought process, seems to be incredibly healthy. So it's good to see guys like that who have been around literally 40 years on the road, you know, doing the right things and taking care of themselves. I aspire to do something similar, and in 20 or so years time, when I'm their age, still be functioning. Been really fun since yesterday. I was looking through some old transcription books and picking out the transcriptions I'm going to include in the new course at Janek's Bass Studio, like this 10-part transcription course, looking at my kind of most important moments in my transcribing career and the things that added the most to my vocabulary. Never forget that Cannonball Adderley thing. Don't even remember the end of it, but that something along those lines. There are just so many moments like that, and I'm going to break down like larger chunks of solos and then take out phrases and kind of explain how I use them, move them around the instrument, and how I learn harmony from that, and melody, and the things that really stuck out to me, and the things that have stuck with me over the past 25 or so years. Oh, why did I go? Lillian. Ah. Lazy. Thank you. Feeling loose today, just not in that kind of flow state of melodic ability or just the ability to get to ideas and to practice kind of working on lines and stuff. Bummer, I had high hopes for today, but good to spend some time with the instrument and get to know these new strings. This is one of those less glamorous days of being in the practice room and just having to run all this stuff because I'm not inspired to do anything else, and because this stuff is really useful and sets me up, you know, hopefully later in the week to be even looser and more kind of in a flow state to work. I'm going to force myself to do that way slower. Time to think, I guess. Gotta stop thinking. Just concentrate on the time and the sound. Thank you. Okay. Last one. Oh no, two more. I think I started on D. So we do the whole octave. Five strings. Time, I think we'll end on there. Something, and now time to get on with the rest of the day. Congratulations again to Rosk 2828. That's awesome. These will be winging their way. I'm not even sure where this person is from. Have yet to hear from them. Literally just announced them as a winner right before I started recording the podcast. So we'll see. We'll do another one in a few months, I guess. Super fun. Again, thank you for spending your time. Thank you for taking some time out of your day and spending what is a very precious resource with me. I really, really do appreciate that. Can't say that enough. Don't forget to subscribe, slap the like button if you dig what you're seeing, share it with a friend. All of those things only take a second, but if you dig what you're hearing, what you're seeing, and want to hear lots more of it, those tiny things really, really help out. So appreciate that, and I'll see you good people of the bass world on the next one.